The California State Assembly passed Senate Bill 793 earlier this week, halting sales of flavored tobacco products. The American Cancer Society Cancer Action Network is praising that decision, joining us to discuss what is next for the bill and how the American Cancer Society Cancer Action Network is involved is ACSCAN board member Kay Coleman. Good morning, Kay. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you?
Well, you know, I think this is one of those issues that I suspect you have bipartisan support, do you not?
Yes, we do. In fact, the bill passed the assembly on Monday by a vote of 58-1. So that is definitely bipartisan support.
And the reason is we all kind of can see the dangers of making tobacco appear to be candy to youngsters, right?
Absolutely. This is what gets the kids hooked. They think it isn't tobacco and nicotine and won't be addictive. But all of the data shows that kids are trying e-cigarettes and other flavored tobacco products at an alarming rate. This is actually a crisis. The U.S. Surgeon General calls it an epidemic.
Not to dismiss COVID-19, but if you just look at the dangers to the relative age groups, you're actually, what you're doing has far more long-range health concerns for youngsters, does it not?
Not just youngsters. Nearly a third of all cancer deaths are related to tobacco use. So tobacco control has always been one of our best weapons in the cancer fight. The tobacco industry wants to hook the next generation of tobacco users. And so, yes, kids are very vulnerable to getting addicted at a young age before their brains are even fully developed, and then having a lifelong addiction or affliction with health issues in addition to cancer.
So what has been the, you know, big tobacco and their lobby, what has been their reaction to this bill?
Well, of course, they have been trying for a long time to carve out menthol cigarettes. And fortunately, our California Senate and Assembly did not carve out that exception this time. So I am sure that they are going to come back and try all sorts of things to get us to reverse this decision. But we hope Governor Newsom does sign this very soon and make it law starting January 1st.
So that would have be the top of the year. And it doesn't, walk me through this a little bit, Kay. It doesn't make it illegal to have these products. It makes it illegal to sell them and have them on the shelves, correct?
Well, the flavored cigarettes were banned by the FDA in 2009, but they left menthol cigarettes and flavored e-cigarettes on the market. So this is what we're trying to stop. It's actually stopping the sale of these products.
And where do you go from here?
Well, we want to thank Senator Jerry Hill for introducing this bill and our local co-authors in the Assembly, Lorena Gonzalez, Shirley Weber, Tasha Borner Harvath, and Todd Gloria, and also for his vote, Brian Mansheim. We couldn't do it without their support. The American Cancer Society Cancer Action Network continues to advocate on behalf of cancer patients, their families, and survivors. So we are the organization that actually helps advance legislation at all levels, local, state, and federal, that will lower cancer rates. So we keep going.
All right. Well, then, congratulations on your win. I know you have more wins and more battles to fight, correct?
We do. Until we get rid of cancer, we will have lots of battles to fight.
All right, Kay. Thank you very much for taking time to speak with us.